Welcome to a new scented video. I'm Stella and in today's video I will be talking all a specific scent profile that I've been loving in the past couple months. This love began last December 2020 with the discovery of a specific perfume, so if you're curious to find out what's today's topic, just keep watching. In December, for Christmas 2020, I bought myself a bottle of Angel's Share by Killian, and since then I have been absolutely loving this scent and the whole idea of a perfume that is sweet and warm and has a little bit of a boozy touch, a lot of sweetness from some wintry fruits and a slight touch of tobacco. So this scent profile is what we are talking about this week. And I have to say beforehand, these perfumes are not dupes, so we are not talking identical scents here. We are talking perfumes in the same realm, something that evokes this specific scent profile. And this type of perfume is perfect for the winter because it's just so cozy and very comfortable to wear, perfect enveloping scarf scents. And I've been loving Angel's Share, and been looking for actually something similar. I don't know if you're like me, but when I find something that I really love, I just want more of the same thing. So I just go and I'm like, what else is like this? Because I want more of this thing. And I don't go and buy like 10 bottles of Angel's Share. I just went out on a hunt and looked for perfumes that remind of this one. So just as a reminder, Angel's Share is an oriental vanilla and it has notes of tonka, cognac, oak wood, cinnamon, pralines, sandalwood and vanilla. These are the official notes, and the scent itself is a heavenly baked, kind of a baked pie type of scent. Really edible. That's the only way I can describe it. It's just so warm. And even though this one doesn't have the tobacco, which I mentioned, it does have this kind of a boozy vibe to it that is just really warm and has depth to it. So this is what usually tobacco scents are providing, a bit of a depth and a bit of a kind of an edge, but not harsh edge, but more like a grounding of a fragrance. And this perfume is just, you know, a stunner, and I've been talking about it so much. So my goal here is finding perfumes that are similar, share the same feel. When I spray it, I can kind of interchangeably wear it without being the same perfume over and over. So with that in mind, my goal was to find perfumes that are similar, and the first one that I came across and was recommended to me is L'Ambre Alexandrie by Boucheron. Absolutely gorgeous scent, and the bottle itself is stunning. It is a huge 125ml of a bottle, so the price evens out. I found this from Notino. This is not sponsored, they don't know I exist, so just to make it sure. This bottle costed me around €100 mark for 125ml. And Angel's Share is 180 for 50ml. So this one is priced much more reasonably, and I will go in and read you the notes because I like to kind of give a little bit of an overview of the fragrance. So we have vanilla, tobacco, benzoin, amber, labdanum, ambergris and musk. And this fragrance, I also love the cap, guys, just have to show that the detail in this bottle is just stunning and it looks just so chic. Yeah, so this one is boozy, also warm, sweet in the same way that Angel's Share is, and you can sense the tobacco in this one, so it does have like a dampness, depth in it, and overall it has the same transparent quality that Angel's Share has, so it does have a complex scent profile, but it's not a heavy perfume by any means. It is super cozy, sweet, boozy as well. I'm looking at the notes and there is nothing boozy, but it is just intoxicatingly comfortable, sweet, seductive, but I can't stop sniffing it. And when I compare it to Angel's Share over here, Angel's Share has more of a, I don't know how to pinpoint it, but it's more, it's a bit more smoky in a way. If that, smoky is not the word. It has this kind of like a fireplace vibe, a bit more edible than this. And it is more present. Now I feel like this is starting to fade a little bit on the strip, while this one still feels a bit more thick and present when you spray it. It does have the vibe of, imagine you have a fireplace and you're drinking rum and you're eating apple pie. This is kind of what Angel Share reminds me. I have to stop sniffing that. But this one in its own right, very beautiful fragrance. So I don't want to like put them against each other. We are not looking for dupes here. This one is extremely elevated. You will feel put together with it. I feel very feminine, even though it's a unisex perfume, of course, anyone can wear it. I can see it on a guy just as well. And it's beautiful. It smells also luxe, so nothing cheap in here at all. I really, really love this one, and I strongly recommend it if you are on a hunt for perfume that has this similar scent profile. I know it's been compared as well with Hermes Ambre Narguile. I have never tried it, and I had a chance to purchase it for a pretty good price, but I actually decided to pass on it. I watched the video by Sebastian, who was talking about Ambre Narguile, and shared that the performance wasn't so good. So I decided that, what's the point, you know? I'm sure it's gonna smell really nice, but if it's gonna go away in a couple hours, there is not much point to purchase it. So even though I was very curious to know how it compares, you know, many of these perfumes have been compared to it, so I wanted to see what it smells like. But I don't think that it was worth the test to kind of buy a full bottle just to see how it smells. So this one, I cannot vouch if it smells anything to Ambre Narguile, but on Fragrantica, again, this is the perfume that has most thumbs up that it reminds of. So just to give you an idea what it smells like. The third perfume that is very similar to the ones that we mentioned before, so Boucheron and Angel's Share, is a new discovery to me. I found it through my subscription, my perfume subscription that I'm receiving every month, and this one I found by accident, and it is by Le Bon Gourbois, pronunciation question mark, and the perfume scent name is 1978 Le Bon Douche EDP. I will have the name on the screen because my French is non-existent. So this perfume, I will read you the notes directly from Fragrantica because on the card weren't mentioned far fewer notes. The top notes we have whiskey, yuzu, bitter orange, wormwood, white tobacco, heliotrope rose, sage, amber, mate tea, patchouli, and cedar. And this perfume, oh my god, actually, it's leaking. Oh hell, I've been spraying so much that I actually have nothing left. If you have a look at the bottle, I have sprayed the whole 8ml sample, and I actually had the chance to kind of choose another one this month, but I decided that I want to continue with this one because it intrigues me, and I don't know if I want to purchase a full bottle because it's really so good. And this one is also kind of like similar price to the Boucheron one, and it also comes in 125ml bottles, as far as I remember when I was looking it up online. But a huge bottle, and great. Now my hands smell entirely, I'm not complaining. So, wow. Very complex, very similar scent profile to, actually this one is more similar to Boucheron than to Angel's Share, but they're all kind of in the same vibe. The tobacco is here, whiskey, you can find the same booziness, the sweetness, and this one has a bit of a powdery vibe because of the heliotrope, which I usually not a fan, but in this case works so well because it just adds this extra dimension to the perfume. And it's also kind of the same transparent vibe like Boucheron, so really elevated. You can spray a bit more and you have the huge bottle so you can reapply throughout the day. I love this one. It is very, 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 very similar to the Boucheron one. And that's why I was kind of like, what should I do? Should I use one and then buy the other? But again, it's a beautiful perfume in its own right. So let's have a look if I can compare them. I have very little here on the strip because I've used the whole sample. But this one is kind of more fruity and this one is more, I don't know, it's more woody. But again, very, very similar with the sweetness. Sweetness level, they're on the same level, I would say. And yeah, no, actually Boucheron is a little bit sweeter. But I've been spraying this one quite liberally, as you can imagine. And I find myself kind of the same experience as the Boucheron, so very interchangeable. And the fourth perfume, which I hunted down because I was really, really curious. I've seen it shown in videos where we're talking about Angel's Share or when we're talking about Hermès Ambre Narguilé. And this is where this perfume was mentioned. This is Wajan by Parfums de Marly. This one is from the men's collection, but I would say that it's like 50-50. Both men and women can wear this. It is actually surprisingly wearable. I was a little bit afraid because I heard that this one is much more stronger, so it's a bit of a beastly performance, but it was kind of what I was lacking because all of the previous three perfumes had a certain transparency about them and I wanted a bit more present fragrance as well in this kind of scent profile. So I was really, really curious about Wajan, and during, I think there was a sale, I used a coupon code and managed to score a huge bottle of 125 ml. I don't think I'm ever going to go through it because it is really, you don't need much. So let's have a spray. Meanwhile, I'll read you the notes. We have cinnamon, honey, osmanthus, benzoin, ambergris, labdanum, artemisia, tonka, vanilla, patchouli and musk. And immediately what hits me when I sprayed it, very good cinnamon notes hit you immediately, but they're not like a scrubby harsh cinnamon, but rather a very well blended cinnamon with the honey. There is the powderiness from the honey that is calming down the cinnamon, and there is no actually tobacco looking at the notes, but the same present body of the perfume as, let's say, in the previous ones. So it gives off kind of this vibe. Lots of depth, and this is only one spray and I'm able to kind of experience all of the different notes blended into one. Nothing is really standing out as dominant, but the whole, like a, again, fireplacey, smoky, warm, sweet vibe continues. And by smoky, I don't mean cigarette smoke. I mean like a warmth, a very comforting kind of scent. And this one is, let's have a look, because it is sweet. I was gonna say that it's not as sweet, but it is sweet still without being cloying. So in here, Angel's Share, Boucheron, and Parfums de Marly. So we have Angel's Share. Very edible. I get most fruitiness from Angel's Share among other things, and I find that it's quite sweet. Yeah, this one is more faint and has a bit less of this woodsiness going on. And this one is the deepest, so it does have much more body to it. I don't find it overwhelming, maybe like my nose is blocked or whatever, but when I spray it, I put like three sprays and I don't find it overbearing. But when I bought it first, I kind of like sprayed a couple times and then I was like, that's not enough. So I went in and sprayed a bit more and I was really like almost kind of dizzy from it. So very, very similar, elevated, a bit boozy, very, very delicious fragrance. And all the three are like, I see this more like a for a nighttime, although all of them could be worn in the nighttime. This one is the most delicious. This is Angel's Share. Again, if I have to choose like a winner or my favorite, these are not battles, so there's no winner. I love all of them. really. I just want to give a bit more options. If you liked Angel's Share, you might like these other perfumes, but by any means I am not putting them one against another, because I believe that there is room for all of them and they are beautiful. I find it very, very hard to have to pick. Why did I even ask myself to pick a favorite? Like, no one asked me to do that, right? So I'm not gonna do it. I am just giving you some options and hopefully create a bit more awareness for the options out there. If you are a lover of the same perfume profile like myself, I will show over here perfumes that are, from what I have read, similar to the same scent profile. So they are in the same vein. And I have not tried any of them yet, but by any means, if you have, please let me know in the comments and I might be on a hunt to try some more. This was all from me for today, guys. Thank you so much for indulging me in this video, listening me ramble about my favorite scent profile at the moment. And let me know, what do you think? Have you tried the perfumes mentioned here? What is your opinion? Do you have any suggestions of perfumes that are similar that I should try? And I'm looking forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye.